entertaining guest. You want to talk about fate? Here we go. I just had me listening to Detroit's own Bloodshot from back in the day. Bloodshot singer Mark Call went to the school that I'm at right now. As soon as Bloodshot came on, I was rolling by and I'm like, oh, we're at Mott High School. This is just way too coincidental. I am going to metal detect up here. Amazing how fate works, because I am going to metal detect one area that I've done pretty good at, but there is an area that I've never detected, and I'm going to show you why I think it's going to be a very good area, a little hidden knowledge from Tripwire. It may work for you, it may not, it may work today, it may not, but I think we're gonna make a lot of dogs angry. But anyhow, I am gonna shut up, I'm gonna grab my gear, and we're gonna do some metal detecting. All right, right by the car, we have our first sound, which I absolutely like. And it is a good sounding sound. No, you can't see the numbers. Well, maybe you can. I can't tell because I'm standing in the shadow, but we're going to figure out what this is. Well, just because it sounded good doesn't mean it is. And of course, I got this facing the wrong way as normal. We have this piece sitting right here. Oh, crap. I don't know what it is. It's kind of just going to miscellaneous section, I'm assuming. But anyhow, I usually do pretty good in this area because it seems to be a lot of traffic with kids and everything. So I'm going to get the camera going the right way, and we're going to detect this for a few. Yeah, I swear these things follow me everywhere I go. We got more fluorescent tube lighting. I don't know how this gets outside in certain areas. I really don't. And this is one of the ones that I really, really don't like. For those of you that follow Deathmatch Wrestling, these are the ones you do not use, okay? So if you're going to the store and buying weapons, don't use these. All right, so far it's been kind of quiet. This is the area I usually do well in, but we're going to keep on hunting this before we head over to where the houses are. See, there's little gates on the houses. People walk out. They may have dropped stuff over there. We're going to find out. I'm not kidding. I am not kidding. Two in a row. Got another one of these. I guess that this is the other end of the first one, I'm assuming. I'm just missing the glass in between, I guess. Oh my god. Two in a row. Hopefully this area gets better as we move towards the school. Alright, well, we kind of got a good sound here. It's in the 61 area, which means it's probably not a penny. It's probably a bottle cap. But we really will not know until we pull it out of the ground. So let's dig this one up and see what we got here. Yeah, we called it ahead of time. We knew it wasn't going to be a penny, but we had to try. We ended up getting more scrap, but that's okay. It's still early. It's only, what, our third or fourth hole? Not a problem. The day's still young, kind of. It's only going to be a one-hour hunt because I just got off of work, and I am tired. But we're nearing the school. Now we're kind of getting somewhere. All right, even though it did not ring up a 91... decided to hit a 90 anyways, and we got our first coin of the day. We got ourselves our quarter, which is good. So when our first coin is a quarter, that's usually a sign of a good day. Boom. All right, I didn't film the last 90, so we're going to film this 90. We do have another 90 over here. It's like really deep, though. I don't really like how deep it is, but darn it. Simplex. So should be right about there. Let's hit it. All right, time for the big reveal. It's, it's right there. Seems hard, and yeah, it is another quarter. That's two quarters today. Very happy, very happy. But, yep, we're going to be over here. Going to detect some more over here. Then I may cut across that grassy area where the baseball thing is, and then go hit that other area. So that is my game plan right now. Said it before and I'll say it again and I'll say it forever. If you are new to metal detecting, hit up your local public schools if you can, because that's a great place to always find coins. Boom. Penny. All right, semi-live dig time, give or take. There is something here. It looks like it's a small piece of jewelry, but I guess I was wrong. I don't know exactly what it is. But the reason why I turned it on is because, is that even it? Yeah, that's definitely it. Not sure what it is. Once again, welcome to Straight Up Metal Detecting. We find weird and bizarre, and this definitely falls into that category. don't know, maybe there's a piece of jewelry and just needs cleaning, but you will see at the end complete, which is in this episode. All right, semi-live dig. Your guess is as good as mine because I forgot what the number is, but we did find it right here. Oh, pull tab. Sorry to waste your time. Pull tab. I'll take it anyway. So I forgot what the number was. It was just like kind of near the top. So that's the reason why I dug it. And I'm like going, well, I'll just grab it. I don't know what it is. We'll do a semi. But anyhow, I am heading over to where the fence line is. Okay, definitely was not expecting this. On the way to the fences, we had a, thought it was going to be a penny or a, no, sorry, I thought it was going to be a dime. But we got this here. It's hard for me to read. The Detroit Institute of Arts. Okay, maybe I can read it. So I was not ready for this. We got something on the back. I don't know exactly what it is. It's kind of neat. This is definitely really, really neat. It's like a little angel. There it is. It's a little angel there. On the back it says Detroit Institute of Arts. This is actually a pretty darn cool find. You don't really see anything like this, do you? And I got lucky on this one. I dig it. All right, we're gonna head down this way. Apparently there's some houses over here with some fences, but there's also this area. Sometimes they put snow up here or something, so we're gonna check down this area here, probably come back up and then get back to the car and head on out to the incomplete. Okay, seeing as how we are by a parking lot, I am gonna assume that this is a beast of a car. I could be wrong. I'm no carologist. I don't know anything about automobiles, but it's very shiny. And it definitely looks like it would be part of a car, if you ask me. And I barely even turned off the camera. All right, we got a long way to travel down this way. And it's already getting late for me because I worked all day. And I accidentally erased the footage of the original sound, but at least I could show you the original hole. It rang up as an 88. And I figured that if we are going to end this show, we are going to end it with this. Over here, we're not ending the show, we're ending the hunt, but this is kind of weird to pull out of the ground. Some type of metal pipe thingy, very interesting, definitely on the older side. I'm not sure what it is, but it is awfully cool. But anyhow, this is gonna do it for the end of the hunt over here, but we will be turning the camera back on if I find anything by that tree, because I'm gonna be heading towards my car, which is kind of hiding behind the tree. So anyhow, I'll see you all at the incomplete.
Starter.
All right, I am watching Brunch with Bean while I am setting up the incomplete. If you guys get a chance, check out Brunch with Bean over on Johnson Family Adventures. She does Mondays and Fridays. I know they end at noon. That's about as much as I could say. All right, this is the incomplete. This is where we go over everything that I found the last couple of times I've been out metal detecting. Last couple of weeks, I mean. We're going to start over here with the Rust in Peace section. Yeah, look at this bad boy. Let me see if I can flip it for you. Boom, there we go. I guess it's part of a sewer. It's just like in the ground. I popped it up with my little spade, too. I didn't even use a real shovel. But yeah, this thing's a trip and a half in. I really don't know exactly what it is, but it's definitely cool and will bring us some money. Over here, we got a couple of rusty old bottle caps. Just a couple of nails over here. I found that little piece right there in the middle with the machine chemical X got me. So it does work. It's just a challenge and a half. This, I have no idea what in the world this is. I don't know if it's part of a break. I don't know what it is, but it's awfully cool. Ultra crap section. Yes, we got ourselves some ultra crap here, big time. Not as super huge as some of the times, but we do got our share of it. The odds and ends section. Holy crap. There is something I wanted to ask about. This little thing right over here. Does anybody know what this is? I swore I've seen it before. I want to say it's part of a golf club, but I could be wrong. If you guys know what that is, please put it in the chat below. That I don't know what that is either, but it is kind of neat, kind of small, interesting. I dig it. It's cool. And just some other odds and ends. I'm not really sure. Like this over here, not sure. But the bottle caps, I do know for sure. We didn't get a whole lot of bottle caps this week. I apologize. I will try to quadruple the amount on the next incomplete. I let you guys down with the bottle caps. I apologize. Service finds. We got ourselves a bouncy ball. Whatever the heck that black thing is. That metal shiny thing, I believe, went to a nail cutter, maybe. An earbud. And again, a mystery piece. I don't know what that one is. But we did find a little clip over here that they used to use keys. But these things break all the time. I would not suggest owning them. Pull tabs. We got a nice little small handful of pull tabs that will be going to Ronald McDonald Funhouse from Corey the Treasure Hunter. You guys, you get these. I know you get them. Donate them. Other people need them more than you do. And speaking of needs in this world, let's see what Scrappy Diggs is up to. Hi guys, it's me, Scrappy Diggs, and this is my find of the week. And where'd it go, TW? There it is. Does that sound good? Sounds good to me. Listen. Awesome, maybe some good treasure. Dig it up, TW. Guys, guess what? I got 2 for 1. Let me show you my finds. Nobody likes that. It's just an old beer can. But there's a penny there. I found a penny. I told you I'm the penny finding puppy. All right, guys. I'm keeping an eye on everything. There's a human coming. All right. I love you guys. See you next week. I'm Scrappy Diggs. All right, Scrappy Diggs found another penny. He is so awesome at metal detecting. Anyhow, let's go over some of the cooler stuff that I found. Over here, just going to take a second. Let me do this. Copper. Big piece of copper that came out. And speaking of copper, we have some copper here. Some copper here, some copper here, some copper there. We also got a piece of brass, and I swore I thought this was going to be steel. No, it's definitely brass, without a doubt. And we even picked up some lead, which I ultimately love. It's the lead. Some of the more bizarre things. We got ourselves a pull tab. That token is from a Shell presidential game back in the day. Always cool to find. We got this button, and I'm pretty sure it might be on the brass side, but it could be copper. I'm going to have to take that and clean it up a lot better. Shotgun shell! Absolutely love it. Here's the Detroit Institute of Arts thing. I'll give you a better look in case you didn't see it earlier. Boom. It's actually a little angel that's on it. So the angel led me to some really cool finds, including coins. Yeah, we got not a ton of coins as normal, but that's okay. Every coin is a good coin. We got ourselves 2 slews of pennies, 3 nickels, 3 dimes, and $1.25 in quarters. And speaking of coins, I actually dug up 2 wheat pennies. Problem. They are so beat up and corroded, I cannot find the dates on either of these. I might do something with them. I'm not going to enter the collection. I'll do something with them. I'm not sure what. But anyhow, this is the find of the week. Yeah, I've been metal detecting for about 9 years straight. And this has got to be one of the most bizarre finds that I ever dug up. I'm assuming this is paint. I'm not exactly sure. Totally silver. I totally dig the color on that. But if anybody else has dug up like a little paint bottle like this, please let me know, because this may be a first in metal detecting from what I see. But anyhow, I also said a lot of times trash can be better than the treasure. Here's your proof. Anyhow, I thank you all very much for watching. Do me a favor, like, subscribe, keep the hunt alive, and we will see you again next week. Thank you very much for watching. Later.